Struggling today. We've got another video for you today to review the iPhone console. Probably a bit low. So we have got the i5 console from RetroGaming.Limited. This is exactly the same setup as our i3 CPU ones. However, there's a significant difference, and that's the CPU itself. So this is the i5 3.5 GHz quad core CPU that also has inbuilt iGPU, I think it's a 4000. However, it also has an 8GB RAM. This system, you can request a 16GB RAM as well. It's entirely up to you, and the beauty of our system is, even though you bought an i5 from us, however, you can still upgrade the CPU yourself to an i7 or another version of i5. The socket is LGA 1155, so you can check on other platforms and search for a CPU that is compatible with that socket. Without any further ado, let's review the performance of the i5 compared to the i3. Obviously, you've got the other video to review and check what that difference, or how much of a difference is actually made by improving or increasing your CPU. So these are the system that we currently have. Obviously, the customer here, Phil, he requested a 1 TB hard drive, which just shy of 100,000 games. Obviously, if you request more games of high-end systems, then obviously that number will decrease. What I mean is, if you requested a lot of PlayStation 2 games or Dreamcast or any of those consoles, they take more space, obviously, then you won't have 100,000 games in the system. Right, so these are the current system. Really good collection, and one thing I do really love about the i5 is it can also play Nintendo Wii games. So let's check one of the games that's on there. Super Mario. Let's start it. Guys are asking what joystick I'm using. Believe it or not, it's just a generic Xbox joystick. Here it is. I'm just using it to test the machine. It's an Xbox 360 joystick that has the other end as a USB into the system. So I'm just going to start now, just to show you the performance of the game. Just to show you that it does work. And if you want to, you can actually have, if you do have a backup game, so you back it up yourself, off Nintendo Wii, and you want to put it on your hard drive, obviously you can. If you want to know what button I just pressed, that the menu appeared, it was just the select button on the actual joystick. Sorry, just get the stand. So for me, that's the select button, that's the start button, that's the Xbox button, but that's the special key where if I want to quit the game, I just press the start and the middle button together and it will quit the game. Obviously, depending on your console or your joystick, how you configured it, you can press the start and select to quit the game, select or the middle button, or just the middle button or the middle and the start button to quit the game. Right, so let's start and play this a little bit. We'll wait for the intro movie to disappear. Do know that this is a 75 inch TV, so it is doing a pretty good job in playing this at the graphics that it should be. So let me just see. So but for some reason the down button is to go forward and the up button is to go backward again. Y button is to select, so obviously we'll try to emulate the remote. I'm not sure how we're going to push it, because we've got to press the down button to go forward and the up button to go backward. So you will have to pay attention to this. I'm sure you can do it in the joypad within the emulation. But overall gameplay, it's pretty good. There's no lag whatsoever, you guys can see. So I'll click the game now, I don't want to spend the whole day reviewing one game. So that's Nintendo Wii for you on here. However, we also have on this system that you probably almost will never find on any of the other retro gaming consoles. Obviously this customer also asked for the Amiga game, so we've got the Amiga 32X, Amiga CD32, and the normal Amiga as well. I'm sure it's just across the way here somewhere. But we do have the standard Amiga games as well, the Amiga 500 and 1200, along with the normal Amiga game. Here we are. Sorry, I'm sure I'll go with that. But yeah, I was talking about that we do have a couple other things that you will never almost find on any other retro console, and that's the Windows games and Amiga on the system. So Windows games, let me just start a couple of them. So we've got quite a few on here. But my favourite, I gotta do that, I love Street Fighter, so we've got those games on here as well. Street Fighter versus Tekken and Ultra Street Fighter. So let's just quickly check this. Show you that they all work absolutely fine on this monster of a CPU, the i5, which runs absolutely fine. If you wanted to, you can tweak probably the graphics within the options on here. If you wanted a bit more snazzy, more, you know, more cleaner, obviously you can change all those settings, but we've kept it at default at the moment, which is optimized to run absolutely fine on the console. There's one issue with this one. Whenever it tries to save, for some reason it says there's not enough space, but there is enough space on the system. You always feel about 20 to 30 GBs free on the system in case you want to put your own game, your own backup game, or anything like that. But for some reason, you couldn't find the code of how or why is it doing this. But for some reason it just... Oh, it worked this time. That's brilliant. So the save actually worked. Training, to give you an option here, to give you a bit of an insight on how the actual graphics are. It's not lag, it's pretty smooth. Pick this up, guys. I'm really surprised that the save actually works. We've been trying to sort that out for some time. One of the engineers might have done something to the code and without telling us, and it actually worked. This is our first time testing this machine, by the way, anyway. Well, I'm personally testing it. It has gone through all the other guys, so I will try my best to see how it is. Right, wow. As you can see, guys, it's pretty smooth.
did. I just played this all day.
So that's your Tekken, Street Fighter 1's Tekken, and also Tron Ultra Street Fighter. There's also King of Fighters on there. Obviously, someone who really loves King of Fighters, they would love it as well. Let me test the Ultimate Street Fighter. And I think this will load on a full screen. Yep, it is full screen. Again, on a 5-inch TV, looks pretty good. You don't have to configure anything, it is pre-configured. But again, if you wanted to change the graphics or anything at all, you can change it via the options and change that. So let's go to training. Have got the DLC packs as well, so you will have a lot of skins for players that you normally wouldn't have it, unless you have the DLC pack. So this does come with a DLC pack, and you can see that Hiro Ryo's outfit is pretty sick. Game that I wanted to show you guys was the Mugen. Again, Mugen, those of you who don't know, Mugen is a system or an application that's designed to run modified game versions created by fans and other developers. So this is basically any games that you love and you've played quite a lot of them. They've been modified to include more characters or more stages, and you'll normally see these games with a lot of streamers stream these games. You won't find them in normal online shops where you can buy them digitally. They are Legion games which are modified. We'll manage to include them onto our console here. So to give you an example, let's start with the Mortal Kombat, for example, Mortal Kombat Tag version. Now, I would 100% say that while you're using our console, we recommend to have a keyboard to hand. And the reason for that is if you do encounter any error message, anything at all, you can quickly press the space bar or escape key to break that option. And also, you can see this game has started in a window mode of a 75-inch TV. It's still playable, it's in the middle of the thing. But it is on a window mode. So what you need to do is, if you have your keyboard plugged in, or if you have a wireless keyboard and you've connected it via the dongle, any 2.4 GHz, you can connect that to the console and it will work. So this is the keyboard. All we need to do is we need to press the Alt and the Enter key together, and that will be a full screen. That's the reason you need to have a keyboard to hand. Now, one of the things you will see, guys, with this one, this is the AI version. You have almost every character that you could think of, in the Mortal Kombat world. So that's one thing I really, really do love about these Mugen games, that you will have characters from Mortal Kombat 1, 2, 3, and also hidden characters that normally you would have not played or had the chance to enjoy them. Right, so
let me just go back here. Let me use the keyboard. So that's a list. Now, for some reason it's not configured properly. So again, guys, if you have a joystick like mine or any other joystick and you want to configure, so configure it to make sure that the buttons work perfectly fine for you. So have your keyboard to hand and light on,
guys can see properly. So you have the keyboard there, so let me just press the escape key and put the keyboard away. So escape key here, we'll go back to the main screen and let me load the game again. This is quite important. You guys need to see this because you will have issues with joystick key or button configuration if you are using a different joystick. So let me put this on for full screen again. Let's press the Alt and the Enter key. Now, see at the bottom, if you go press the arrow down button, you will see that it's changing to different options. If I click on the option, press the Enter key, and then on here you will see there's an option that says Input Config. So if I press the F1, there's a short key in front of it says F1. So if I press the F1 on the keyboard, and then one of the options it says there at the bottom, it says joystick enabled, so make sure that is enabled, and joystick config. So how to enable that, so if it's not, just go the arrow up and down button, and just to make sure that it is enabled on there. So on here it is enabled, so if I press the F2, and then it says config for player one, if I press the F1, now I'll grab my joystick and I'll configure it. So for up button, up, down, left, right, let's just put A, B, C, X, Y, Z, and the start button. So once you've done that, go put your joystick back away, go back to your keyboard, and you press the escape button, escape again, you go down where you see load option, and you go across once, and it will change from load to save. So if I press the back and forth, it will change from load to save. So once you click on the save button, it should say the save there. You just need to press the enter. So once you press the enter, it will say options save. That's all you need to do. So once the options are saved, press the escape, and you've gone back to that bit. Put the keyboard away, grab your gamepad or joystick or joypad, and now it should all work absolutely fine. So if I go on to train, press the X button, and let me choose a character. God, there's so many characters in there. I'll select the Sub-Zero. Who do I want to play against? I want to play against another version of Sub-Zero. Stage. Obviously, it's important, guys, that you configure your buttons to the way you like it. Have your, combos, whatever you're trying to do, work perfectly fine. Right, so let me get this back to normal. So that's why you need a keyboard to configure some of the Mutant games or some of the joystick. Not all of them will require the configuration. Some will actually work absolutely fine, but some will need reconfiguration. So if you want me to try one more game, let me try King of Fighter Zillion version. Sorry guys, I didn't have to stand with it too much. Should be sent now. I do like to test it FBI, I don't like to go on my video capturing card. It just looks, I know it looks too professional, but this is just how it's supposed to be. It works absolutely fine, so yeah. So here you can see that I don't have to configure my joypad, but if you do want to, it is in the options. You've got an option again, you can see that option, it says input config F1. If you have a keyboard, press the F1 on the keyboard, or you can just use your your gamepad. So let me just go up to here, escape, let me see what characters we've got. Well, so you can see the library of these. You can see on the left hand side I'm choosing a tag team that's two players, or a single person, so I'm going to choose a single person. Look at the amount of characters that you have. You know, it's tons and tons of characters that you probably won't be able to find in a normal single fighter game. Let's see the gameplay as well, how the system runs it. I will play it for now. You get the gist of it anyway. You know, these games, the amount of characters and the amount of fun that you want to have with these is just unbelievable. It's unlimited. You know, the characters on there that you probably have never played before. You've got games that you've probably never played in such a way. You know, you've got Street Fighter, you know, combined with SNK, Capcom, and all the other fighting characters you could ever think of. Again, we also have Sega Model 3 games. We don't have all the games, we have some games on here. Again, you know, if for any reason any of the games isn't working, all you have to do is change the emulator. So I will show you that, how you can do that. You can play with the settings somehow, you know, some of the settings, and that will make that possible. So just to give you an example, if you were playing one of these multiplayer arcade games and you wanted to play the game but kept crashing, so what you've got to do is you press the start button when you are on the game, the select button when you're on the game, and you click on the advanced option and you click on emulator, and from there you can change. If you do have an option from auto, here we've got the libretto. Select that and then you can change a different core. But if you're not sure, go back and leave it on auto. But yes, changing these emulators will change the game and the way they run. Yeah, let's just try this one in auto. And if it did fail or it didn't work, then that's how you change the emulator, and that's how you can then, you know, make sure that the game is actually working. So these are the arcade games. It says here insert coin. The insert coin, you just press the select button, and you can, the amount of times, the more you press, the more credit at the bottom of the screen. You can see it's just putting more and more credit. Press the start button, obviously select your button. Over 80,000 on this one. If you start tapping, I mean, you want to use games on most of the other retro games, so you can show that they all work absolutely fine. Sometimes you just have to let the game run. So again, to insert a coin, you just press the select button. Press the start button. Sega, arcade console, I again, loads of games on there. Loads of Capcom 1 versus SNK games are. Let me just play one of the heavy games up here to show you how it actually plays. You just gotta let it run for the first couple, so you don't have to press any buttons. The system will take and they will check a couple of the settings before it starts, so let them do all the settings, and once you see the actual game icon like Wellington Chino Sega, you can then press the start button or the, the space, sorry, the select button to insert coin, and then you just press the start button. Right, we'll quit this game now. Capcom versus SNK. Let us know first. So this is loading, so we leave it to low and then we'll decide. So once it's fully loaded, now you can press the button. So if you press the select button, you should start to insert coins. Here we go, insert coins. No shambles, but we managed to win. Right, we'll quit the game now. That's why we have to know exactly the same thing. It's an arcade machine developed by Sega. Again, so many games on there. You just have unlimited fun with it. Atari games, loads of them on there. Different versions. Please do remember some of these games will require a keyboard and a mouse to play as intended by the original system. So one of those will be the Amiga games. It will need the original, just like the original, will need keyboard and mouse. So in my video, Nintendo Entertainment System will just play quickly and check out the game. Alright, we got a frag. That's your Nintendo. You also have Super Nintendo games as well, obviously. Super Famico, Japanese version, SNES Hacks, so SNES HRSNES, SNES Hacks version. So these games are being modified so you can have different stages or different experience. So let's just say you've got Super Mario World with Sonic. When have you ever seen Sonic in a Super Mario World? But there you are, these are the hacked version of the games that's been modified by fans for you. Nope, don't have the flash as I expected. Well, that's Sonic for you, Nurse of My World. So these are all the hack versions. SNES H, that's what it represents. We also have Satellite View games. Guys, there's unlimited games on there. You would have tons and tons and tons of fun, with these consoles. We also have a few Nintendo, GameCube games, Nintendo GameCube games. Obviously, GameCube is one of those consoles, even though this console you just see runs Wii games pretty smooth. You will have some issues with some of the games which are not 100% compatible with the emulators, but that's by the by. Most of the games will work, and if some are not working, future updates will make it possible for those games to run and play absolutely fine. Obviously, you've seen the Street Fighter game now on the Nintendo GameCube, and it works absolutely fine. There's no crackling sound. We'll see how it plays now. The gameplay should be smooth, not laggy, but if it is laggy, obviously we have got then which one of these contents to be afraid of. In terms of software, and that will be possible for you to run absolutely fine. Now we're not going to play each and every thing for that event. We requested Game Boy Game Boy Color, Game Boy Advance, Virtual, Pokemon Game, Sega Master System. Again, you will have the hack version on some of them, which is the hack version. Mark 3 is normally Japanese version, so Japanese, the game that has not been released anywhere else apart from Japan and Korea, you will also have those in the view. Mega Drive again, you've got an option here that says Mega Drive H, that is the hack version of the game. To give an example, you've got Golden X, the Green Hands, you also have other games, Mortal Kombat here is the hack version, just to showcase you what does that mean. So normally on a Mega Drive, Sega Mega Drive 2, you had the Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, that was it. So this is the additive version, or hack version, which I assume will have all the characters from Mortal Kombat 1, 2, and 3. Yep, there we are. So almost every other character you can think of are on the Olympic Shokan, Goro, Barak. I don't have any words for it. We'll click that. So you do have all the other, every single game that's ever released on a Dream, Sega Mega Drive. You also have games for Sega C. You also have Sega 32X games on here. Sega Saturn games, again guys, Sega Saturn is again one of those difficult consoles. Some of the games would run absolutely fine, some might not run that smooth. So if that is the case, when you are under Sega Saturn, let me just go back to Sega Saturn, all you've got to do is press the select button and then go back to advanced option, emulator, change the libretto, and then port, change to one of these other ports. What they will do is, if the game isn't running smooth, one of these will make it run smoother. So these are different the emulators, which some of the games are compatible with one emulator and some are compatible with the others. So please do play around with the Sega Saturn options, because if they do work, the system can play Dreamcast game absolutely fine, and Sega Saturn will do all of it. So we'll play a couple of the games here. This is Sega Dreamcast. Loads of titles on here, loads of games. Obviously our customer did want Dreamcast games, so we included that for them. And you can see some, Again, you can also change the option here as well. If you want to change the emulator, again, you do exactly the same thing. You press the select button, and then you change the emulator. As you can see here now, it's in Japanese language. So if I go back, press the start and the select button, sorry, for the special button, press the select button here now. You go to the advanced and the emulator, by click on libretto, and then rebreathe. Go back and play exactly the same game now. This should automatically change the language now. So this is how you can play around with the system a little bit. If you want to pre-configure it, you can, but we normally use the default settings for users to modify it in a way that they want to do it. Some games, if they do start in Japanese, when you change the emulator, that should fix the language. But obviously, we do include games from all around the area, all around the region. Yeah, so this is definitely a Japanese title. Right, runs pretty well. Now a little bit of a glitches, if you don't know if you guys noticed, but I can notice there's a little bit of a glitches. Again, you go back to that select button once you're on the menu, press the select button, the advanced game option, and changes back to auto, and you see that glitching. If not, obviously you can play with it, you know, with these settings, smooth games and all that option to make sure that it runs absolutely fine. We'll try one more game before we call it a day. Crazy Taxi. Good game to run, good game to test. I will showcase one of the other games as well as here, which is that this console can also run a PlayStation 2 game. Obviously not every single title are compatible at the moment, but the ones that are compatible, they will work absolutely fine, which I will show you now anyway. So let me change this one. Games in here. Let's select Virtual Fighter. This is a PlayStation 2 game playing on this console. Not every single game is compatible, guys, as I said, with the emulators. Hopefully, future updates will make more and more games compatible with the system, but it's just to showcase that the system can actually run the game. Which is pretty good, pretty insane with the i5 the system. Thank you. Anyway, we won. But yeah, runs pretty good, pretty smooth. You've got PlayStation 2 games, PSP games, loads of PSP games on here. So imagine taking a PSP game on a full screen. So you can run games in here quickly. It's pretty insane that you're able to play a PlayStation game on the TV there. I'll quit that now. You also have PSP mini games, loads of mini games, PSP mini games. There's just over 3-4 mini games as well. Wonderful PC games. I could review this whole thing taking all day long to review. Again, as I said, Amiga games you will need, for some of them you will need keyboard and mouse to play, and for some it just will work actually fine with the joystick. You don't have to configure anything, but obviously for some you will have to use a keyboard and mouse. So we'll play this last game and then we'll call it today. Anyway, we'll quit this game now, you can save state anyway, this is why you need a keyboard for some of them, and the reason you need a keyboard is if for any reason, if you wanted to make any changes or anything at all, then you can make those changes to the game. In order to play this game, I have to go and press the escape key on the keyboard and then the Alt F4 key. Right guys, any questions, anything at all, please do let us know. I hope you've enjoyed this video. There's some fantastic games in here that, you know, normally you wouldn't find on any other consoles or anything at all. We do try to you know, enhance the system experience. So, for example, this is why also another reason why you need a keyboard is if you get any sort of error or anything, you can just press the space bar to move ahead on to the next, move ahead with the loading of the game. Right, thank you again for watching. I hope you all enjoy your evening and speak to you all soon.